Sasha, and today I am bringing you all a video on how to make your own weird DIY school supplies. And now that I think about it, all of these DIYs, except for one, have to do with making school supplies look like makeup. And I know that sounds really weird, but it's actually pretty cool because you'll have, for example, let's say mascara. And on the outside, it looks like it would be regular mascara, but then you open it up and it's not mascara, it's got a different use. You'll find out what I'm talking about later on in the video. But yeah, so it's basically like how to make weird looking DIY school supplies. So I really hope you guys enjoy this video. And without further ado, let's just go ahead and get started. So to start off the DIY pillow notebook, all you'll need is this furry pencil pouch. I got mine from Target, but you can honestly use whatever you'd like. It doesn't even need to be a pencil pouch, but I feel like this made it a lot easier. So all I did was cut down the sides of the pencil pouch, and then I cut out the material on the inside. After cutting down both sides of the pencil pouch and cutting off the zippers, you will have this rectangular piece of fabric that fits right on top of the notebook. Then I opened up my notebook and lined up the material with the edges of my notebook, and I glued down 3 of the edges out of 4 with some crazy glue. Then after I had 3 of the 4 edges glued, I took the one edge that was opened and stuffed the middle with cotton balls. And then I glued down the 4th side once the notebook was full. And then now you have this DIY pillow notebook. And I was actually really weirdly surprised at how comfortable it was. So now, if you finish a test early and falling asleep is an option, this will make it a whole lot easier. This next DIY is how to make a crayon look like lipstick. It's so weird, but it's actually really cool. So first, you're gonna need to take some sort of old chapstick container or cheap chapstick that you bought and just cut off the chapstick on the inside, and then clean out the inside of the lipstick tube. And now you can pick out whatever color crayon you want. I just went with pink. I mixed the darker pink and then the lighter pink. Next, you're obviously gonna wanna take off the paper covering on the crayon. And a really easy way to do this is to take an X-Acto knife and just carefully cut down the side of the crayon, and then the wrapper will come off really easily. And now you're gonna want to melt the crayons. And all I did was break my crayon up into a few pieces, put it in a spoon and hold it over a candle. And it actually melted fairly quickly and it was really easy. Once the crayon is all melted, you're just gonna wanna pour it into the lipstick tube. And this part was, not gonna lie, kinda hard for me because I kept missing the lipstick tube and it got all over the surface. So I had to do a few crayons in order to fill up the tube. But if you have better aim, it'll be a lot easier to do this. And then afterwards, just put the crayon lipstick into the fridge until it hardens. And then you can take it out and you have something that looks just like a lipstick, but it's a crayon. Whiteout concealer, all you're gonna need to start off with is an empty or old concealer. Mine was basically all gone. And then you're gonna want to take some sort of pliers and take out that little rubber piece on the outside of the concealer bottle, if that makes any sense. It just makes it a lot easier to clean out the concealer. And now it is time for the whiteout to come into play. So before you do anything with the whiteout, you're gonna wanna take off the rubber lining on the whiteout because this makes it a lot easier to pour the whiteout. And then it's as simple as that. Just pour the whiteout into the concealer. And be warned, the whiteout was actually way more liquidy than I thought. And I kept spilling it everywhere and it created this huge mess. Then my hands got covered in whiteout, and it's actually been a few days since I filmed that video. And I still have whiteout all over my hands. It would not come off. So sadly, for the rest of the video, I will have ugly, gross whiteout hands. Sucker for your novel. I'm wearing your goggles. Virtual reality. Hey, it ain't what it cost you. For the eyeliner pen, the first thing I did was take out the eyeliner. I just bought a really, really cheap eyeliner. If you're gonna do this, buy something cheap because I don't want you guys wasting or ruining an expensive eyeliner. And then I took the ink cartridge out of a pen and trimmed it so that it would fit into the eyeliner tube. And once I had that adjusted, the lid still wouldn't go on the eyeliner because of the extra pen tip. So then I took out the ink cartridge and I actually trimmed the eyeliner itself. And then once I had that trimmed, I put the ink cartridge back into the eyeliner and the lid fit on perfectly. And then there you have it. Something that looks like an eyeliner, but it's actually a pen and it's super cool. Who would have thought you could make a regular mascara a marker? Yeah, I didn't, but it's actually pretty neat. First, you're gonna wanna take out the rubber lining of the mascara. This will just make the overall process much easier, and it makes it a lot easier to clean out the mascara. Then you're gonna wanna use any marker of your choice. I just used a dry erase marker, and then I took these pliers again, and I kinda just ripped the marker apart until you get the ink cartridge for the marker. And then I just put that into the cleaned out mascara tube. And as you can see, the cartridge was sticking out a little bit. So then I just took some scissors and trimmed it. And then as you saw, I took out the ink tip to the marker and I trimmed the part that connects the whole marker together. I don't know, it's not the lid, but it's the top of the marker. I have no idea how to explain this. It's that part right there that I just put the cartridge on. And the reason I had to trim it is because then it actually fits in the mascara tube, as you can see right now. And then I assembled the marker back together so I had a marker poking out of the mascara. And then my dad actually drilled a little hole in the lid, as you can see here. And that way you can close the marker and easily screw on the lid, if that makes any sense. And there you have it, a marker disguised as mascara.
I really hope you all enjoyed that video. If you did, definitely give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel by clicking the big red subscribe button down below. And while you're down there subscribing, make sure to turn on post notifications. For my channel, all you have to do is click the little bell by the subscribe button, and then you'll get notified every single time I upload. And if you take a screenshot of your phone screen showing that you have post notifications turned on for my channel, make sure to tweet me the photo and I will try my best to follow as many of you guys back as I can. My Twitter is Sasha_Morga. And make sure to go follow me on all of my social media. I've got Instagram, and I highly recommend you follow me on Instagram because I'm starting to do giveaways on Instagram, exclusive giveaways that you won't get on YouTube, so go follow me. And I also have Twitter, Snapchat, and Musical.ly, so make sure to go follow me on everything. Well, that just about wraps up this video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye! Deuces.